"I've never seen a storm like this come down." Those were the words of a longtime Denver resident today. The city got pounded. It didn't take long for the water to pile up.
The cars just keep coming through and floating away, and the big trucks try to come through and tidal wave us. You know, it's kind of fun. It's kind of like a beach, but on concrete.
This is in front of our house after a huge thunderstorm. 17th Avenue. You can see how fast the water is moving. It's like a river.
There was so much water, it was like a river, pushing all the bark and debris, and it overflowed right into the basement.
I heard the glass break, and it was this window wall right here.
In a matter of seconds,
I just couldn't believe my eyes.
The gushing water flooded everything in Randy Riggin's basement.
It was like a giant sink drain, and everything was just pouring.
Gas it, dude. Oh, they totally stalled. Thanks for stalling, stupid.
Well, that is right, Karen. Really, to believe this story, you have to see it. We're going to pan our camera over and show you exactly what we've been looking at. Police on the scene now confirmed that there are three cars down there. We're located at 38th, and the street above is Fox. Two cars are completely submerged. You can see that third car peeking through. And if you take a look over to your right, you'll see an I-25 sign right there. We're told that that sign stands at 10 feet high, so the water roughly is at least 8 feet. Police tell us there was a person trapped inside the car, which is now submerged down there. That person called 911 screaming.
Citywide, there are $1.2 billion worth of improvements that need to be made. But Alicia's neighborhood is not on the project list. The fault is on them. Get bigger pipes, get better pipes. You're telling me a 120-inch drain versus a 4-inch drain, neither are going to be able to handle the amount of water? That's baloney. Denver Public Works says bigger drain pipes wouldn't have helped in Thursday's case. We had 3 inches in about an hour. Regardless of the quality, age, and condition of the system, there are very few systems out there that can handle that kind of rainfall. The city says expanding how much water Farrell Lake at City Park can hold has certainly helped with the water flow. But for residents here, 2 blocks that way, no flooding. A block and a half that way, no flooding. A block and a half that way, no flooding. Us, Noah's Ark was waiting.
I've lived in Crestmore my entire life, since I was 5 years old. And this is the worst monsoon season I've ever seen, as far as this particular area is concerned. I've never seen it absolutely pour down water and rain for a whole week, over a week now. It's unbelievable.